What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 66 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Brilliant Diamond. And at this point, I've decided to begin the endgame process of this Ultimate Let's Play. I'm going to be rematching all of the gym leaders. I'm going to go in chronological order, starting with Orberg City. Now, all of the gym leaders have really vamped up their lineups. They all have a team of six, and they're really high level. I think they're in the mid-60s to low 70s. So I'm going to be put to the test here, unlike the trainers I've been dealing with in the last few episodes on these hidden routes. So we're going to see exactly what these guys bring to the table, and hopefully I can knock these guys out before I go round two with the Elite Four and Cynthia. And boy, that's going to be a fun to do. Anyways, let's see here. Gotta find the gym. All the gym leaders are back at their respective gyms. And we'll go ahead and get started. I'm planning on doing two gym leaders per episode. I really have no clue how long each of these battles are going to be. And then I'm going to save the Elite Four and Cynthia for one big episode at the very end. At that point, I'm going to completely throw away my 30-minute time limit. But anyway, it's time to begin the rematches, starting with Roark in Arbor City. Hey, you actually came. Welcome once more to Arbor Gym. Ever since the day I lost you, I've been rethinking everything I know about the strengths and weaknesses of Rock-type Pokemon. Over and over and over, and then it hit me. Rock-type Pokemon are simply the best. Alright, we're ready for round two, Roark. Let's do this. So yeah, he's got a full team of six now. He's going to start out with a Tyranitar? Are you kidding me? This is a pseudo-legendary Pokemon. It's a Rock Dark type, actually. One of the pseudo-legendaries from the Johto region. You fully evolve a Larvitar, you get this beast. And it's going to nearly whip up a Sandstream, so we're going to be dealing with a constant sandstorm to start this thing. This guy's at level 68, so we'll see how well my level 71 Gyarados deals with this guy. I'll start with a Waterfall. Okay, it took a Waterfall with relative ease there. And it's now going to hit me with Stone Edge, but I'm able to avoid the move. I think one more Waterfall will put it away. Obviously, this sandstorm is not going to impact Tyranitar at all. Here comes another Waterfall for you. Alright, one down, five to go. Probably should get some very good experience from these guys, which will help greatly, even though I'm probably still going to grind before the Elite Four and Cynthia. Alright, who's next? Now he's going to bring in Probopass, which is the evolved form of Nosepass. I think I'm going to go ahead and keep Gyarados in for really as long as I can, since he's kind of the lowest level of my team. I think this guy's straight up rock type, so let's try a Waterfall. I know Bulldoze is not going to work on this guy. I think he's got Levitate. I'm pretty sure of it. I'm going to need a secondary Waterfall to take this guy on, though. Oh, he knows Discharge. That could really... This guy knowing Discharge, an electric move. Perfect weapon against Gyarados. Go ahead and knock it out with Waterfall, but the Sandstorm is probably going to end up taking out Gyarados here. So I'm probably going to have to change Pokemon. Yeah, Gyarados has had his fill. Knocked out two of Roark's Pokemon. So I think next is time to bring in Roserade. But I'm going up against an Aerodactyl. Oh boy. And it knows Unnerve. This is a bad matchup here. Let's try Giga Drain. It's going to use Stealth Rock. Good move. Not only is this guy dangerous in terms of attack power, but its speed as well. It may actually be able to keep up with Weavile. So I'm a little scared right now. Let's keep going Giga Train. At least I can recover the HP I lose from the Sandstorm. But if I get hit with a flying move, that's going to be probably Goodnight Irene there. I was going to use Roar, forcing me to change Pokemon. Oh, this actually is going to work out just fine, because I want Weavile to take this guy on. And it's actually, I got hit with that Stealth Rock and the Sandstorm coming out. And it's got that weakness to Rock. Let's hope Avalanche can take it down here. Here comes Stone Edge. I might not be able to use it. Oh, that's a bummer. I mean, Weavile had the perfect weapon, but it wasn't quick enough. So I think I'm going to use Roserade again. Stealth Rock kick into play again. One more Giga Drain, hopefully can knock it out. I always get nervous when fighting Aerodactyl. That's why I love having one of those on my team whenever I'm able to get one. I do have Old Amber on me. At least the Sandstorm's out of play now. Now Relicanth coming in. It's a Water Rock type, so this is perfect for Roserade. And it's a lower level, so let's go after with the Giga Drain. Yeah, Relicanth had no chance. Alright, and now Armaldo, another Water Rock type. I think he'll keep Roserade in. This guy's already hitting level 70 now. This is the evolved form of the fossil Pokemon Anorith. I want to say he's Bug Rock? I forget exactly if he's Water Rock or Bug Rock, but let's see what a Giga Drain does. Not a lot. Managed to avoid Stone Edge. Stone Edge seems to be his weapon of choice here. I'm running out of Giga Drains here, so I gotta take this guy out quickly. He's gonna use a Citrus Berry. Good tactical maneuver right there. Here comes Stone Edge. And that puts me in the red. Let's keep going out with Giga Drain though until we run out of it. I think that actually took it down. Yes, it got a critical hit. So that worked out just fine, man. Got a lot of my HP back. And Roserade's gonna level up. And lastly, we got Rampardos, so his Kranidos has evolved. Let's bring in my heavy artillery, and I'm going to bring in Garchomp. Here comes my trump card, witness the true strength of rock types. Alright. Yeah, I took the stealth rock attack, but let's see how it handles an earthquake. Down in one shot. It's that critical hit. Ooh, what a match. And Roark goes down again. What? It can't be even that wasn't enough? Apparently not, Roark. I gotta hand it to you. I gave that battle all I had, but you still beat me fair and square. I can see how you made it to the Hall of Fame. You really are a top trainer. Here's the sticker I always use. Now you can use it too, whenever you want. Got Stone Sticker A. Nothing will ever weaken the bond between me and Rock-type Pokemon. I hope you come visit again sometime. Well, I don't think I will, unfortunately, because after I beat the Elite Four and Cynthia again, that's when I'm going to end this project. Now, before I go any further, I do know that there's a second rematch where they're even higher. I don't think I'm going to go to that third tier, though. That means, because grinding is going to take me long enough for the Elite Four and Cynthia, and I don't want to end up doing it again, because I do want to move on to other projects after this is all said and done. So anyway, we're going to be heading to Eternacy next. We're going to be dealing with Gardenia and her Grass-type Pokemon, so I'm going to lead off with a Crobat. Now that we're all healed up here, it's time to fly to Eterna City. Yeah, I'm wasting no time here. So it's possible some of these rematch episodes may be a little shorter than my normal episodes, but I do have a battle plan in place, and whatever happens, happens. That's the Iago there. Alright. Gotta remember where the gym is. Are we on the eastern side of town? Gotta get my bearings here and find out where everything else is. Here we go. Here's the gym. Luckily, I don't have to deal with the trainers again, but I might have to deal with the maze again, though. Okay, so can I just make my way straight to Gardenia here? Yes, I can. So I don't have to go through the maze again, thankfully. You can't be waiting, T.U.G. When I first saw you, I just knew it. Sooner or later, this kid was going to defeat the champion. And now look at you. You're just oozing with the winning aura of a really tough trainer. But it makes me think, if I can beat you now, then I'll be the strongest trainer there is. Yep, when you're on the top, everyone's gunning for you. Even the guys that used to call themselves the best. Alright, Gardenia. You two have a full team of six. We're going to start off with Jumpluff. Really? Evolved form of Hoppip through Skiploom. But Jumpluff is not all that powerful of a Pokemon. Unless you got some kind of secret weapon, which I don't know. But you're probably going to fall real quickly to an Aerial Ace. Are you going to try Leech Sheet on me? That's probably going to be your best bet to try and recover some HP at least. Maybe force me to switch out my Pokemon. Okay. So you can take a little bit of punishment there. But I don't think you're recovering a lot of HP, are you? Maybe I'll take you out with another Aerial Ace. I'm gonna throw Sunny Day into effect. I'm guessing you're setting up for some maybe a Solar Beam? Because it's one of the extra effects of Sunny Day. Not only powers of Fire-type Pokemon, or attacks, it'll also make it so you can use Solar Beam in one move instead of two. But nevertheless, Crobat was able to win that battle. He's at level 75 now. Now bring out Torterra, who's Grass Ground if I'm not mistaken. I think I'll let Weavile take this one and knock that Leech Sheet out of play here. Torterra, the final evolution of the Turtwig, the grass starter of this region. Yeah, it's grass ground if I'm not mistaken, so I'll hit this guy with some avalanche. Oh, you know, Stone Edge? Ah! And again, I walk right into an unexpected attack like Stone Edge. And apparently it's got a life orb because it lost some HP when it did that. Well, I guess I'm going to have to put Crobat back in. Alright, let's take to the sky. And she'll avoid Stone Edge again. I keep forgetting to watch out for that move. It's the perfect counter for an ice type, which he has, I think, a double weakness to. And Stone Edge coming for Crobat now. Wow! And Crobat survives, toughs it out with 1 HP. And that life orb kicking into play here. I think I can finish with it with Aerial Ace, though. You can use full restore. Good move. I hope a fly is gonna be. You know what? I'm actually gonna U-turn. And yank Crobat while he's still alive. And who can take a rock move? Maybe Garchomp. I got a hunch it's gonna use Stone Edge again. Yep. And I know that Garchomp could take a bit of a hit there. And I'll finish you off with Dragon Claw. Alright, that's two down. Garchomp and Gyarados both level up. Next up, we got a Breloom, a grass fighting type. I know you only got 1 HP left, but Crobat, this is perfect for you. Just to see how long you can last out there. Get an aerial ace in. It's trying to use Focus Punch. But if it takes damage, it's going to flinch. Not that it really matters, because aerial ace took it out one shot. Okay. And the sunlight fades away. Now a Sunflora coming out. I'm going to go ahead and just bring in Infernape to kind of finish this battle off, I guess. And Sunflora is not the best Pokemon out there. Go ahead and use Blast Burn. Down in one shot. And Infernape hits level 76. Cherim now coming out. Has a different form depending on the weather. I'm going to have to rest a turn. It's going to use Sunny Day and it's going to transform. But at the same time, you're giving me a power boost. Flower Gift. Now it has blossomed. Not sure if that's going to do you any good, though. Let's hit you with a Blast Burn. Because by putting Sunny Day into effect, you're also giving me a power boost to Blast Burn. Oh, I had a Focus Sash on. Enabled it to endure that attack. Oh, good play, Gardenia. Good play. Forced me to rest a turn, but you're going to go ahead and use a full restore. Unfortunately, your Focus Sash is gone. And I'm just going to hit you again with the Blast Burn and put you away. Alright, next up is Roserade. Your last Pokemon. Don't you think it's natural to save your best for last? Roserade was your ace before. It looks like it's still your ace. Heck, it influenced me to raise a Roserade of my own. Grassy terrain coming into play. So now everybody's going to heal every turn, I think. Everyone's in full strength anyway. I'll just hit it with another Blast Burn. Hopefully this will put him away. Burn the grass around it. And no chance against Infernape right there. And Gardenia goes down. Wow, you've totally bested me. Wow, you really are strong. Just how did you raise your Pokemon to be that tough? Took a lot of time, that's all I'm going to say. Well, anyway, here. As thanks for that battle, I'll give you my favorite sticker. Leaf Sticker Alpha. But that doesn't mean I've given up. I'm up for a Pokemon battle every day if you are. Well, I'm done here if you ask me, so I think I'm going to go ahead and head to my next port of call and then call it quits for this episode. So next up would be, I believe, Veilstone, because that's where Maylene hangs out. Her and her fighting Pokemon. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and heal up and get ready for the next battle. And I think I will actually lead with Crobat. I'll keep him up front. Alright, well, I know it's only been about 20 minutes, but I'm going to go ahead and call it quits here. We'll take on the next two gym leaders in the next episode. So until then, this is T.U.G, saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.